That's scary, I don't like heights.
So I don't know how I'm getting off the roof.
Literally stopping light.
Welcome back to another build video, guys. Today I'm going to be starting the roof on the Cedar Hollow. So if you remember last time, we stood up all four of the walls. I've officially braced everything down to the foundation, so I'm going to give you guys a little breakdown on how we're going to be doing the roof. Also, when I wrapped up the walls framing video, I didn't do a really good job giving you guys a tour because I was dead tired, but I'll give you a quick little tour of what the space is going to be like and then walk you through the roof. So here's the front entrance, right? You got your parking pad. I'll build a little like platform there. You'll walk into the living room here. You got your big old sliding door, the wraparound windows right there. This whole wall will be kitchen. And then over here, we have the bedroom and bathroom. So yeah, now we gotta put a roof on it because the rain is coming tomorrow and this is not good for having rain when all this is still just raw wood. So the plan for the roof, the way I planned out this design is so that I could buy standard dimensional lumber that would work for the roofing trusses without having to have intermediate supports. These beams that span from wall to wall are 20 feet long, and that gives us a 2-foot overhang here on the front side of the home. So I'll have some like lights recessed in this soffit up here, and it's gonna be cedar, and you'll see all that when we get to it. But then on the back side here, we'll have about a foot overhang. That's the general plan, so I'm gonna go snag the rest of the lumber. It's at the front of the driveway right now, so let's go grab it. So far, this is the bulk of the lumber that I'll be using for the roof, and it's cost me this much money so far. But I have a feeling there's gonna be a little bit more because I think I cut the quantities really tight on this. All right, we're all loaded up and ready to go, but if you can see, the trailer is only 10 feet long and the boards are 20, so they're hanging on the ground here. But fortunately, Elon's helping me out here a bit, and he's gonna go give it a tug for me. There it goes. This is so awesome. He's just taking my lumber for me. See you later, buddy. I'm serious, I'll do this in one take to show you it's actually doing. No one in the driver's seat. Hey, look. Ta-da. Ta-da. No one driving. M's not in the back either. Real talk though, I'm a huge Tesla nerd and my referral link is down below, and I would love to go to the Cybertruck reveal. So if three of you guys that are watching this video buy a Tesla with the link below, I get to go check out the Cybertruck, which is like my dream truck. By the way, Smart Summon doesn't work super well. It's only worked for like 10 or 15 feet of the driveway. So I just brought this first piece into the home, which I'm gonna be setting this up as like the template area. So I'm gonna measure all of the other roofing rafters based off of this one. So you see I got the little widow's peak in there and I beveled the end. But this cut right there is perfectly level with the ground, which is where we'll attach our fascia siding and the cedar to the underside. And then it's the same thing on the flip side here where you got the little widow's peak there, and then this is beveled to keep perfectly flush right there. I don't know if any of you caught this, but put a huge bruise in my leg last time when I was framing the wall. So if you guys wouldn't mind liking the video and subscribing, I'm going blood, sweat, and tears on this one. Like I thought, the walls flare out a little bit at the top and the middle. So I think I'm gonna have to ratchet strap them and pull them together a little bit because I gave the wall jacks back to my coworker. You guys know what I'm dealing with. So the other side over there, the little widow's peak, is set directly on the wall like this, but this one has about an inch and a half gap, which when I measured plumb, I did see it, the wall's leaning a little bit this way. So I'm gonna take a ratchet strap, anchor it to the floor over there, and try and pull this in. And once I get it sucked in to the point where this is flush here, then I'll go screw these in, and that'll be our like first establishing point, and then we can start mass production. I keep promising mass production and we just don't get there. So before I keep framing the roof on the Cedar Hollow, I need to thank the sponsor of this video, which is Surfshark. Just like how we're building a roof to protect everything that's under it from all the elements, Surfshark does the same thing, but for anything you do on the internet. With me running a few businesses, both in the media business and the Airbnb space, online security is essential to my success as a business owner, which is why I went with the Surfshark alert system, which notifies me right away on my phone when any of my personal information has been leaked, which is essential so I can nip it in the bud if something ever does happen, so that I'm not going months with my personal information being scattered all across the internet. Some of the cool bonus features that I didn't even know came with Surfshark is that you're able to stream shows and movies from all across the world. There's certain shows that aren't accessible in certain countries, which you're just able to switch where your server is based out of, and you get a whole new wide array of shows and movies that you can watch, which I thought was so wild and I never knew. Another really cool feature that I've actually used a handful of times in the last couple weeks is buying flights at discounted rates. So if you didn't know, airlines are able to inflate prices based on location and time, which if you're able to just switch the location that your server's based out of, you're able to get discounted rates on flights, which I've already used a handful of times buying flights back to Chicago to go visit my family, which I can absolutely appreciate saving a buck here or there when I'm in the middle of a build like this. These things always tend to run over budget, so every penny counts. So aside from knowing that your personal data is safe and off the internet and out of hackers and scammers' hands, being able to stream all sorts of new shows and movies that are accessible all across the world, and being able to save money on flights, really, what are you waiting for? So click the link down below and enter code Devin to get 3 free months of Surfshark. And I can't recommend Surfshark Alert enough. Getting that notification right when your personal information is leaked online is key to shutting it down right away. I'm so thankful to Surfshark for sponsoring this video, knowing that I can sleep well with all my personal information safe where it should be. Thanks again to Surfshark for sponsoring this video, and let's get back to framing the roof. There we go. We are right on at the peak here. We'll go check the other side. Other side, same deal. It's perfectly aligned here on the back side. So I'm gonna go check Plum one more time, and then we can start setting more rafters. So I'm gonna be spacing my rafters out 24 inches on center, which means that my blocking needs to be 22 and a half inches wide, so that every 22 and a half inches we set the next 2x4, so that dead center is every 2 feet, which will make sheathing the roof way easier, because going in 2 foot increments, 2, 4, 6, 8, boom, that's a full sheet of plywood, and then we just rinse and repeat and keep laying plywood. I forgot one thing. When I cut the widow's peak, it has these 2x10s sit down a little bit lower. So I have to take a corner off of this to make everything flush out so the sheathing doesn't sit higher than the rafters. Okay, the first two rafters are up, and I will show you what we got going on. So this is that bird blocking I was talking about, and just because I'm trying to get as many of these up before it starts raining tonight, I'm not gonna be drilling the holes. So we'll do this at a later date, which will be kind of a pain in the butt, but at least we can do it once we're dried in. But I gotta be drilling some holes for ventilation here. So the insulation, I believe, sits like, it's either 6 or 8 inches tall. So there's gonna be a little bit of an air gap that flies over here for ventilation. Ventilation is so huge for just like all the season changes, and the roof gets really hot in the summer and like cold in the winter. So ventilation is key. So I'll be drilling a whole bunch of holes. I'm not sure what diameter yet. I'll have to look up online. Okay, so I haven't been out here in a little bit, so there's been like a 4 or 5 day just break, but we've gotten some pretty wild rain out here. So I tarped the whole Cedar Hollow, and we have a couple boards up or whatever, but bear with me if some of this stuff doesn't make sense. I just flew in from Chicago like a half hour ago, and I have a few hours before the guest checks in. So today we're gonna be setting a bunch more roof trusses here. Hopefully I can get them all done and show you guys the kind of tricky detail that we're doing here on the sides, where there's going to be an overhang coming off where the trusses aren't just like sticking out past the house. So it's been a couple rainy days, so I'm going to get this tarp off here and start grinding on the roof.
Oh, that didn't work. Oh my goodness, I just got freaking soaked.
That sucks. I'm literally sopping wet. Okay, so we're up on the roof here and I've set the last truss that's running across. So you can see the overhang here. I think this one's like 14 or 15 inches is what we set it to. But the other side that like looks out over the feature area has a 24-inch overhang. So what we're gonna do is mimic that 24-inch overhang at that end and copy it here so that people looking from that way, like the money shot of the house, we'll see a consistent roof line going all the way around. And we'll have like lighting that's overhung going around the perimeter and it'll be really cool. But for the time being, I'm gonna set a bunch of kickers coming off here and they'll hang out 24 inches over and just be tied right into this guy. Okay, so this is one of the first pieces that's gonna stick like this overhanging. And the way I have it set up, or at least roughly plan to have it, is so that the weight is carried by this 2x6 wall. So when I put this in, the 2x6 wall sits dead center. So all the load that sits on the overhang, like say when it's snowing or raining super hard, it's all equally distributed because there will be the same amount of weight here as it is here on the roof. So I'll go throw this up and show you what I mean. Let's change the plans. I'm gonna be installing all of those kickers once I actually start adding the cladding, because riding the ladder up there and trying to get it perfectly lined up so that it falls 24 inches on center so that the panels land right on them is not gonna work when I'm zipping around on a ladder. So I'm gonna go finish the rest of these roofing trusses the rest of the way, and then we can start throwing some cladding, working our way out, and then I'll install those end eaves, I guess, if you wanna call them, something like that. Check it out, all of the trusses are set now. These were a total pain to set by myself because you have to like hoist one end up on the other side. Just total pain, but they're all done now. There it is. So I'm gonna copy this overhang and put that over here. So the overhang overall looks uniform all the way around, except on the backside. All the main roofing trusses are on. We're gonna go bring some 4x8 sheets of plywood in here. So one, I can bring you guys upstairs and don't have to worry about the tripod falling down through the trusses. The portions that overhang the kick out past the side of home, it'll make it a lot safer for me being up there instead of just like floating, straddling some kind of freaking truss or something. So I don't know how I'm gonna do this yet, but then we'll figure it out. So last time I was out here, I started setting all the sheathing so we actually had something to work off of. But now that I have about half of the roof sheathed, I can bring you guys up there. And welcome to the top of the Cedar Hollow. So this is all that I got done end of last week. I still have to frame out these corners here, which I'm waiting to set an end board that runs there to support it. I'll show you guys over here though. So essentially what we're gonna be doing is I'm gonna keep running the sheathing all the way along here until we get right about here. And this is where we'll stop the sheathing and we'll start laying out all of these kickers coming off. So you can see I'm running about 50 on this side of the wall and 50 on that side of this wall here. And that's so that when this eave is loaded with snow, there's an equal amount of snow on this side and that side, so the weight is perfectly distributed down this wall. I didn't want to have just little boards sticking out and there being too much weight on the outside of the eave, since this is a 2-foot overhang here. Yeah, this is one of the sketchiest bits. I have to take this 20-foot board, huck it over the side, and screw it in because it's gonna brace the corners here, but it's kind of sketchy. Now, I gotta take this guy. I marked right here, which this is where it's gonna have to line up to so that my roof line's completely flush in the front. And I'm gonna put a screw in. Okay, don't fall. This. Oh, the plywood is like curling down so it won't slide in. There we go, baby. Okay, that's a good temp hold. We'll go fix the other side. Okay, so with this board, there's a pretty gnarly warp, not only because it sat out in the rain but also it's been like cooked in the sun and everything. So, and this board is angled down a little bit. So I figured out a cool way to align these, which I actually didn't watch a TikTok. I kind of just figured this one out myself. So, placing a screw right there, hammer there, and then you just screw it just like this and it pulls the board in. And then we can do the fine little tune just like that. I should have started the screw on the other side first. Okay, so now all I essentially have to do on the corners is just fill it in, add a couple more slots right there, add a couple more little boards going 1, 2, 3, and then we're connected. I just throw the sheathing down over top. That's scary, I don't like heights. But there we go. All we gotta do is cut the piece of plywood, plop it on there. But the reason why I framed it that way, so that this end piece that's connected to all of these other runners right here helps to support this piece of blocking in the middle. So now everything is like fully supported by the walls and we can go do it on the next corner. Now we've wrapped up both of the corners on the north side of the house. They're looking pretty good. Now I just gotta keep plowing along here, do all those kickers out that way, and then do the same thing. Only way down just got sealed in underneath this piece of plywood I just laid. So I don't know how I'm getting off the roof. I actually forgot. I put this ladder up here. Well guys, that's a wrap for framing the roof video. So as you can see, we got all our overhangs braced, all the sheathing is on top, and overall I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. It's not 100% perfect, this is my first go at framing and I was doing it by myself, but I mean, I love how it turned out. So please make sure to like this video, subscribe to the channel. I really appreciate you guys, and in the next video we'll be cutting in skylights, putting the shingles on, doing all the drip edges, and I'll be walking you guys through all the waterproofing details. So you're gonna wanna make sure you don't miss it. We'll see you in the next video, peace.